when it breaks apart. The satellites fall. We'll be laughing up above when this black hole swallows us all. Swallows us all.
But I had to screen the call because I didn't recognize the number and have terrible social anxiety.
Stop going!
Hey, come on, man. That's real rap. They said, we got you, Canel. How about him? I said, on one condition. I can use this voicemail as a skit on my next album. What it do, you little fucking battle groupie? You ain't popping in the city. Had to bribe the promoters to even get on the card. Went and dropped him a 50. I am being honest. He getting in his pockets and it's shifty. To get ahead with the president, he had to go under the table like Monica Lewinsky. I'm in the driver's seat, baby. I came to put on a show for the fans. I just wrote me a plan and know they fucking with me. Cause it's all clicking like a poetry slam. They just got me on the card cause Genick likes the Simpsons. Well, I'ma get to quoting them there and I just see Colin Black. I'm reading Homer's hand. Yo, I got this shit in the palm of my hand. Cause that's where I write all of my best rhymes. Oh shit. I forgot in my next line. Oh yeah, and Lenny's white. We can go back to back punches. I got these lines for days, but we could do the absurd jokes. And I cook him in his own traps like climate change. That's how they know my style is great. I'm on some Fendi shit. That means he effed either way. Boy, my whole demeanor's sick. I ain't changed it yet. I just stick to my guns like a bayonet. You look so confused between the drugs you take and where you dress. You could go from H&M straight into H&M. Like, come on! He is on enough ketamine to lean the Trojan horse. And the fucking army. All these tranquilizers have fucked his heartbeat. Well, I'm gonna bring it back up again. Like, I ain't gonna let that conversation pass me. Straight for the neck like Eddie with the car keys. Australian boy. About to throw his shrimp straight on the fucking barbie. I'm letting my hunger speak like Mahatma Gandhi. They have to wish him luck. Cause he was skating on thin ice when he was coming past me. They tell him break a leg. Well, I fucking do him like Tonya Harding. Bro, this shit is so peak for you. And this is the start of my mountain to climb. I'ma bury him so deep he's gonna be like every other working age Welsh male. Fucking down in the mines. So fucking national pride on my Jonah shit. Let's see how Wales stomach boy when he get out of line. Fucking Welsh people. You mean Scottish people that were too pussy to get addicted to heroin? Like, fuck, where you from and the losers that you think that you were better than? I'm here to get what's mine and claim my inheritance. They knew I was next in line. And that's the only reason they put me next to kin. You should have named your album the Kentucky Derby. Because the track's all dirt. You're 35 and fucking trash. I'm here to make sure all your bubbles burst. I got 15 on him. Had more impact and put in more work. Now I'm running around the world with a city on my back like it's tour merch. I am sorry for being so indirect, but like, what do you want me to say to this guy? Talk about his brain and it's fried like everyone else does. By now, he's probably well aware he's had a terribly shit life. Bro, I don't mind beating a dead horse. Just not one that's dead on the inside. Bro, they tell me Canel been grinding. Like what, his fucking teeth? Bam, a wasted opportunity. He ain't gonna remember this shit in the week from the way dude's been hitting the speed. It's like he took the phrase blink and you'll miss it way too literally. Ted!
To do heroin. That's a weird angle. Just give me half hour and a fucking train ride to Brixton after this battle. Yo.
Let's go.
But yo, listen up and listen well. First ain't fuck, second ain't canal. prick, Mbop was shit.
Let's go.
Pile of shit, mate. But Ted thinks this is his break on the big stage. No, it isn't, lad. You're hopeless, missing focus vision. You begged it here off cosigns. I got here with no assistance. I got the coldest written, the flow is different. I have Kojay believing in globes and shit like solar systems. Watch his arse fall out like Ebola victims. Lad, you've got ears. Watch his arse fall out like Ebola victims. Lad, you got Iggy Azalea. We got Ocean Wisdom. Aussie Sharks get shat on. That's Osha's wisdom. No difference. I'll slap man's head for the dough. Homer Simpson. And I don't give a fuck if your older sibling's Owen Wilson. Just dead. What's happening there? Anyway, say it. No. I don't give a fuck if your older sibling's Owen Wilson. Just dead your bed talk. First battle overseas, but you're a tugboat to a dreadnought. Mm. Your streak won't end your, and I'm about to end yours. You're scared of the pressure, so spare me the lecture. We don't care when Ted talks. You need to start working, mate. Hustle, work your brain muscle. Stop looking like an expensive dog owned by a suburban gay couple. Lads, I'm in. Yo. You do a bit like a weird Labrador. Well, here's to par all your failures. You take tourist wildlife pictures with no qualifications. You just take pictures of koalas with Asians. Lad, I'll par this guy. You know fuck all, Pugwall. And your par's a shite. And your chance of heartbreak, high. See, I met my share of pricks like you, bruv. Time to try and pull birds who were too drunk. They've already puked up, still wearing the top that they puked on. And when they get back to yours, you share a toothbrush. You cunt! Your local pub still has a sign that says poker in the front, liquor in the rear. You see an unconscious bird on the pavement and you lick her in her ear. I'm telling you, he's the type to take over drunk birds and R. Kelly. He's a foreigner and a rapist. That's alien and predator. Yo, your mum's arsehole looks like a smashed tarantula. Your mum's arsehole looks like a smashed tarantula. And since she's Australian, it may be venomous. Look, you think you know. Look, you think you know, but you're the shittest going. I get more reaction with a slogan. I got more layers like winter clothing. Doesn't matter if I'm spitting sober, drinking stoned, or sniffing coke. I'll drag this cunt from pillar to post exposure floors like whistleblowing. See, all your shit is filler, bro. And when you see Ted Bundy, you ain't killing no one. So piss off back to your stinking home and ditch your hopes of winning, bro. Because I'm too gutter to stay in my lane. I'm shit at bowling.
Okay, alright, unpopular opinion. Going to raves when you are 30 years old is not a mad flex. But he has to, because the Raven reminds him of the love that he used to have him. Edgar Allan Poe with a fact check. He got a jaw swinging like a middle-aged whack couple. Shit's always looking mad tense and it is barely hanging on, like you are to any youth that you have left. Bro, you are going through the shittest midlife crisis in human history. Like, think of all the ones that you have heard of, right? Fall out of love. Gotta end your marriage even though it'll hurt your wife, so you go for a younger girl. But she just using you for your money, so you gotta pay for a whip for her to drive. But Canel started wearing a snapback when he was 35. See, he found no long-term happiness through consuming drugs, so turned to rap as an outlet, but should've pulled the plug. No matter what you do, you'll always be a useless cunt, so even if you find yourself, you're still gonna try and kill yourself like a looper does. See, bro, I'm not sure if it's the crack that you smoke or the ones that you fell through, but you should have stuck it. Yo, I am not sure if it's the crack that you smoke or the ones that you fell through, but you should stick to chasing the dragon, because that's a lot more realistic for you to get to. Fuck a midlife crisis. This shit is exponential. You couldn't make yourself a worse person if you tried, like Dr. Jekyll. But fuck the negatives, man. Don't let them ever defeat you. Try some alternative methods to help cope with the stress that you've been through. Even tried voodoo. But whoever's got the dolls being very deceitful because they sat there stabbing it with the heroin needle. But they acting like Canelo's got this crazy personality to bring in new fans and build a large base. And if you consider cocaine dependency to be a personality trait, then you've got a terribly hard case. How are you going to stabilize the scene when a chemical imbalance is all that you are, mate? All these substances to enhance your performance, but you're still bottom with the card, eh? That shit's like Lance Armstrong coming in last place. Bro, you remind me of O'Shea. If O'Shea was a whack cunt. He O'Shea playing for United, top of the table, getting his cash up. You O'Shea playing for the Black Cats, having bad luck. You a fake fraud and there's no avoiding it. He did a shit on a shark. You have a fish tank that looks like a public toilet. Bro, he shotgunned a beer with Poe Rich in front of hella hands. He shotgunned a beer with Poe Rich in front of hella fans. He got a Pepsi can and hit up Holohan. Bro, from my verse to Flex Digits, you studied the tapes. The shit's deeper than the stuff that you say, and the beer in the hand is just one of the traits. You are in love with him, mate. You see O'Shea is a father figure just so he will come on your face.
Oh, shit.
Plant him in the dirt. You want people to be a fan of your work, have some respect for it first. I'm talking shoulders back, head up. Dude's walking around like he's still got his hanger in his shirt. Let's go, man.
Let's go.
Yo, you had some bars there, but there's one thing I've got to check you. What exactly did you mean by the word exponential? catch it on the fucking tape. Anyway, fucking most Aussies' ancestors arrived in all types of different ways. Some wanted a better life because they were poor, trying to get paid, others were shipped against their will for war crimes and mistakes. Your granddad was on the run from war crimes in The Hague. That is the legit reason. He looks like the result of inbreeding in Sweden. Fucking his nan took him there, he took your nan in a U-boat to live there because he asked someone if Oz had spiders. They said, yeah, big Aryans. But anyway, lad, enough about your Nazi tank commander granddad. Let's examine some facts, lad. Now, I'm normally known for making stuff up when using angles, but this is fucking truly factual. Your hometown is famous for being Australia's line dancing and country music capital. Now, I'm trying to get my head found out in bread. Now I'm trying to get my head round how inbred your area is, and lad, I'm fucking truly baffled. And you play shows in them ends, dude. Dead cool. Seriously, how can anyone attempt to respect you playing shows to a select few bent dudes? Your tour is cancer because of how much of a queer he is, so I'm Zodiac killing Ted Cruz. That's why this dickhead is poor with his inbred hick tours. Fucking New South Wales. I'm the original North. And I swear this is true. Imagine him, Dunners and Vega getting wrecked in a room. Now I'm trying to figure out which one gets sent to the shop, because I'm guessing it's you. Fucking Dundee heads round telling cunts to get him a beer. Lad, I will force you to get in the beer for everyone here. Fucking I'm telling him he's getting everyone in England shots. Teddy's sharing them.
Nah.
So you're a twee acoustic cover of a proper hard remix. You can hit up Lordy for something Argentinian. We'll show this Aussie hard dealers. And Jim's was shitter than ever against you and still kept it borderline. But this is UK, I'm used to stormy skies. And I put on for the chalked out guys. In fact, I can't die, I just come back to life. Start snorting my chalk outline. Jim's 2-1 you, even though he choked. Vega beat you 3-0. You need a Street Fighter cheat code. But then I saw you had a battle with Oxide. Sweet, bro. Except it turns out I ain't the one we know, did songs for Neutrino. The only time I want to see a battle alongside Oxide is Bound for the Bow, Bound for the Reload! Bound for the Bow, Bound for the Reload! You shit.
You got this battle because you support the culture. No one cares about the shit that you quote. No one likes any of the shit that you quote. No one likes any of the shit that you quote unless it's on a message board. No one has time for any of the shit that you wrote. You are a supporter, not a performer. Should've left that costume at home. Well, fuck it, I'll turn this shit to Briggsy versus Soliloquy. Third round, he getting smoked. Fucking nah.
Oh, yeah,
nah.
That's
fire.
Nah, bro.
That's fire. You're right.
Fuck that,
yeah.
Fuck that. Fuck that, I'm gonna turn this shit to Sopranos. Finish this shit with an enclosure, I'm strapped in. I could snap at any moment, I know your medical record. You're gonna see history repeating over, I'm strapped in. I'll put you back into a coma. Oh! Oh! I'm just here to document what's wrong with the system like Michael Moore. They say in a coma is like being at home but the lights aren't on. But electricity is something that Cannell could never quite afford. He out here squatting at home like a sport. He made the natural progression from government assistance to life support. Bro, imagine having a hospital and this guy is in one of the beds. Just assume he'd OD'd and turned his brain to vegetable juice. You can't fathom the lack of respect the staff had for you, dude. They spat in the food that you were fed through a tube. Bro, this is top five shittest taxpayer waste of money of all time. It's not a miracle that you survived. It's that government expenditure kept you alive. The fucking health system should be...
NHS!
The fucking health department should be met with a fine. Like, imagine the trade-offs they made, like... Yo, we're gonna have to turn these six orphanages into mines just to keep Cannell in his prime so we can write another terrible verse about his shitty life. You got a face that looks like an un-ironed shirt. You just a large, lazy guy that puts batty fish on the top of his stargazy pie. Fuck it, chalked out. I came to put my name on it. You have an incredibly low ceiling if we remain honest, because no matter what you do, we're only gonna know him for The Rock, like Dwayne Johnson. Bro, they came here sleeping on me, but when I leave, holy cow, Prince gonna have a pillow with my face on it.
Now! He said he's gonna put me back into a coma. You was calling it, G. He was right, that round bored me to sleep. But yo.
Hold it down.
I ain't seen all your battles, but I get the gist of your work when you spit in a verse. Four bar setup, fill up the time with filler at first. Act all aggressive when you're spitting a verse. And then nick a punchline from a UK battle and act as if you did it first. You stinking nerd. More guns than GTA with a cheat code. Harry Baker did it first. Talk with the hands like Italian people. Carlton Shanks did it first. Your Kevin Spacey bar, that was lazy ass Jack, again did it first. I could have paid more attention checking your battle for better examples, but mate, I'm not a friggin' nerd. See, back home, that might work if you sell it right, but we got a rule around here, never buy, get it right. I'll have your bird spreading like Vegemite and I'll send you to hell with one box. I'm a Cenobite. See, I kill streaks from the get-go, no decision just because I said so. Fuck your Facebook feeds, I ain't the type to get trolled, and now young rollerblades is next in line to get rolled. Trust me, you're going back to your country hungry. Outback cunt attempting a long shot. Wolf Creek. You never should have doubted it. Fucking head back to your outback town from this and I'll treat you like seagulls. I'm talking drowned in shit like Round the Twist. Yeah. Old school reference. Oh, yeah. But in Oz, you respected, I get it. So to them, if you win, it's nothing less than expected. Just a shame I came in guns blazing like the remake of Death Wish. Ask the lads on No Coast or East Coast Connection. I'm Wrexham as fuck, but Americans get it. Eternal underdog that never gets credit. Pulled down whenever I level up like Tetris. I MC like Escher because the levels are endless, with a history of sickness like medical records. My bass hard to reach like a pelican's nest is lad. I'm cocaine and hookish. You're jelly and Nesquik. Yo, I could turn up and still spit the best bits. Or I'm untouchable on some Elliot Ness shit. The old heads don't want it, because their reps are worth testing. I can pull out a win when it's never expected. The new guys think they have a chance, so I'm the head they're obsessed with. I'm nobody's favourite. But everyone gets it like a Wetherspoons breakfast.